Thank you once again. Well, ladies and gentlemen, on that note, let's quickly march ahead to our next speaker session as well. And meanwhile, once again, I'm going to request you keep those tweets coming using hashtag ScreenAge. We'll also be making an announcement of our second Twitter contest winner as well shortly. So on that note, our next speaker, in fact, comes with over two decades of experience in the FMCG sector across functions, consumer segments, and geographies. He's an alumnus of IIM Lucknow, and he's also the brain behind Asia's biggest social community of women on the internet, before Facebook happened, of course, which is called as Sunsilk Gang of Girls. Well, today he will be talking about the mobile marketing performance dilemma. So ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Sandeep Verma, President, Bajaj Corp. Please put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen, for Mr. Sandeep Verma.
Can I have a hand mic? Can I have a hand mic? Okay, so first things first, the first correction that I need to make, I don't have over two decades of experience. That really makes me sound very old. I have only 17 years of experience, so yeah. So I thought that I should just set the context right at the beginning. I think, so you guys have gone through a whole host of presentations, from the morning. The current one that I'm supposed to be presenting on is called Mobile Marketing Performance Dilemma. Two things that you will not see too much of in my presentation are too many numbers, too much data, because you are already aware of all the penetration data and all of that. So I won't be using too much of data. And as far as possible, I've tried to move away or keep myself away from too much technical jargon, okay, because I don't like jargon myself. So this is going to be a very, very simple presentation. Hopefully, it can be interactive. Please feel free to stop me in the middle of my presentation wherever you have a doubt or if there's anything that you didn't agree with or need some more clarification. Okay. So these are the three things that we will basically be talking about today. Are marketers and agencies collaborating enough to grow the mobile marketing pie? How can marketers decode the measurement puzzle to indicate the ROI in mobile? And what can be done, of course, to grow the mobile marketing spends in India as such? So they look like, actually each one of them is almost a session, a complete session in itself, especially the one in the middle. But let's see what we can do in the next 28.2 minutes. Okay. So let me just start with the first one. Collaboration. I think presenter before me was talking about something like this, that he has an agency and then he wanted to meet the marketers to understand, to try and explain how he can help solve their problems. And that is basically what collaboration is all about. And why is collaboration so important or needed? Okay, I'm struggling a little bit with this. I need to point that side. Okay, sorry, thanks. Yeah, so this is why collaboration is needed. Any guesses of what this looks like to you? Any guesses? Yeah? Statue of Liberty, yeah. By the way, today is the day when the Statue of Unity is being inaugurated in India. You know that, right? Statue of Unity, as you guys would know, is about two times the size of Statue of Liberty. And what do you think is the size of Statue of Liberty in meters or feet? 92 meters, yeah. Absolutely. I mean, and around 300 odd feet, yeah, for the old timers like me, 300 feet. Now, why have I shown you this Statue of Liberty? Any guesses? What is the relevance of a Statue of Liberty in a mobile marketing conference? So here it is. Sorry. Okay. So this is a fact. These are some facts. All of us, each one of us, actually gets about 300 feet of content every day on our mobile devices. So just sitting here with your thumb, you're actually scrolling almost a Statue of Liberty daily, every single day. Okay, it's been proven. And who knows, maybe in the next 2 years, you'll start, climbing the Statue of Unity also, which is almost two times the size, right? So that is my point. Now, how do you break through these 300 feet of content, the Statue of Liberty sized content? And that's where the point comes in. So three things that we really need to do essentially, yeah, to break through, to get over the Statue of Liberty of data. One, you need to be brave to stand out from amongst this 300 feet of content. So you need to be creative, strongly creative. You need to be contextually relevant. You need to make sense to me as a user. Yeah. So I need to be relevant to the user. And you cannot just resize and reject content. You have to create content for mobile. And I think all of us, all the marketeers, and whoever is a marketeer in the room, and including myself, all of us are largely guilty of this resizing, right? We do some resizing of our content, we put it on the mobile, and we are happy with the mobile marketing efforts, yeah? So that is really not mobile marketing. So you have to create content for mobile. And if these three things need to be taken care of, I think the point is that the first point, which is about being strongly creative, is really the domain of the agencies, the creative agencies, the people who make the creative for you. Contextually relevant to the user. Okay, who understands the user the best? The marketeer, right? So the marketeer comes into the picture here. And hence, if you have to create a content for mobile, both the agency and the marketeer have to work together. So that is my whole point. And that is why collaboration is so critical, you know, to break through this 300 feet of Statue of Liberty worth of content. Now, how do we do that, essentially? What do we need to do? I think, well, a lot of us have, you know, there have been times in our lives when we were working with the ad agencies or various agencies where we've had this kind of a relationship, you know, with our ad agencies. Now, how do we get over this? Three things. Sharing, trusting, and upskilling. And I'm going to be talking about each one of these points in detail in just about a minute. But these are the three big stages or work that we need to do to collaborate a little bit better. They sound very intuitively commonsensical point, which is what they are actually. But just to, you know, get into a little bit more into detail of each one of them. What do I mean by sharing? Okay, sharing of relevant data. Yeah, there is, the amount of data that is available today in the world, you know, there's it's like mines and mines of data. We just spoke about the 300 feet. But the point is, when you mine this data, are you able to create some relevant data? Are you able to share some relevant data with your agency, which is helping them in creating some unique creative? So for example, you know, any marketing brief, whether it is mobile or television or print, if you ask the marketer, you know, to explain who is your target audience, and if the brief goes something like this, female, 18 to 25, living in metros, studying or working, unmarried, has a mobile, watches TV, you can pretty much cover the whole universe in this. Okay, but if you have an important one, why is this running ahead? Yeah, but if you have some relevant points in this, for example, the point in red, she commutes to work on trains, okay? Or she commutes every day for 1 hour, but she doesn't drive. It means that 1 hour is available to her every day when she in the morning, meaning half an hour, you know, while she's going, and maybe half an hour while she's coming back. Now, that is relevant information for that particular, for the agency. So this point, the point in red, is actually the relevant data out of this entire reams of data. So ensure that you are covering relevant data. You are sharing relevant data with the agency. You are not giving them, you know, piles and piles of data and expecting them to sift through it. Can I just have that small 1 minute video played now? I'll just show you an example of some work we did where we managed to mine a lot of insights. Yeah, so just a very small example of, a very simple AI-powered chatbot. You know, chatbot is not something which is very unique anymore. But basically, the reason we created this chatbot was actually to get some more relevant insights about the consumer. Because like the video said, the demographic, the diversity of India is so huge that we couldn't really give her specific insights about her skin type and what she should do. So the idea was to actually get more and more data, you know, and keep getting better by using the AI-powered chatbot. So, you know, if you engage with your agency, and this was something that we created completely in partnership with our digital marketing agency, BC WebWise. So if you are in collaboration with the agency, they can guide you on how to mine this data and how to use this data further. So that is obviously the first point. Okay, the second point, and something that all the creative agencies absolutely hate about the marketers, which is the overdoing of research, okay, or using research to kill creativity. Okay, so basically, we finally got through all the market research required to launch a new product, but we are retired now. So again, a very real-life sort of example. Point here being, do not over-research. There's no point of you over-researching things, and don't use data. You know, this is more. These are more like guidelines for the marketers. Don't use data just to quash creativity. Yeah, or to, you know, or also a lot of us try to use data just to show that we know everything about everything else. So to show your masterful knowledge, etc. So use data properly. Share research for a purpose. Eventually, what is the goal of this data? The goal is for you to be able to create a stronger bond with the consumer. So are you really doing that with all the research work that you are doing? Point number three, this is for the agencies now. When you are, obviously it's important for you to come out with new technologies. So the JPEG actually gives you an idea of what I'm talking about. How many of us have heard this, you know, from the digital agencies? What is the big campaign idea? Well, we are doing digital. We'll do Facebook, we'll do YouTube, we'll do mobile, we'll do Pinterest. Okay, so what are we going to do in all those channels? I don't know, we'll figure that out later. So point is, don't just show what technologies you have. Show what is relevant for the brand, for that specific brand. So it is obviously important for you as marketer to use the range of technologies. So when the agencies come to present these technologies, they need not try and dazzle the marketer. Okay, that is not the, I mean, it's not going to serve any purpose. You need to come and tell them how it can be used for their specific brand. So make it relevant for the brand. Yeah, don't just try and dazzle the marketer with all the new toys. You know, everybody likes to play with shiny new toys, but he may use it once and then not understand why it is helping him. So best is from the beginning itself, show that it's completely relevant. I know this is a personal example. I remember a couple of years back, maybe 3 years back, when Snapchat was like really, really big. I mean, it still is big, but this is like 2-3 years back when Snapchat was really big. And one of my brand managers came to me to show me an ad on Snapchat which he had made. And I kept trying to see the horizontal view on the mobile. And then he kept on trying to make it vertical. Because I really had no clue on what Snapchat was and why it was important for me to, you know, look at the video production vertically. Now that is just information which the agency needs to provide, that for this kind of a platform, you need to change your creative in this kind of a manner. So that's a very live example of mine where I sort of was not aware of what Snapchat was at that time. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I think the other very important thing, collaboration between the agency and the marketers, it has to be a collaboration between equals. Okay, you cannot have one side sort of leading the other. Otherwise, these are very real life conversations, by the way. This really happens, the one which you're seeing over here, where the marketer says, I want SEO. The guy says, yes, sir, we can deliver it to you. And he comes and says, the SEO process is initiated. 2 days later, we'll soon see the results. And the marketer says, but I don't see the website on the top page of Google. These are real live insights. Okay, and a lot of us may not even be smiling because they may still be wondering what is wrong with this, actually. But there is something wrong with this. Or the one on the right, like us on Facebook for a long-term meaningful relationship. And the marketer asks, why are we still on Facebook? I thought the social media was last month's campaign. Now, if you don't upskill the people, okay, these are the questions that you will need to, I mean, you will get into. So if you are doing SEO for the marketer, I'm just giving you an example. it is important for you to tell them what the hell SEO is. Okay, what is SEM? What is these are very basic things I know, but you have to still tell them what to expect from whatever it is that you are presenting to them, because it will come back to bite you in the butt later. Yeah, so just a summary, quick summary of the 4 points on collaboration and how we can get better at this. First, share relevant data. Share, but not just to destroy. Do research, but not just to destroy other stuff. Show latest relevant technologies. Yeah, make a, you know, figure out how it's relevant for the brand. And last one, last but not the least, definitely upskilling. Upskilling of the marketeers for latest technologies. Upskilling of the agencies to understand the brand a lot better. So both sides need a lot of upskilling. If you have these 4 things, then obviously collaboration will be a lot better for sure. Sorry. Okay, the other 2 points. What can marketing professionals decode? How can marketing professionals decode the measurement puzzle? And what can be done to grow the mobile marketing spends in India? Now, some facts which you guys would be aware of already. So I'll just share them with you very quickly. If I'm allowed to, yeah. So, this is a research which was done across Asia-Pacific, which basically says that people spend about 2x the time on the mobile screens than on television. But the mobile spends are around 20% of the overall media spends in APAC. In India, by the way, this number is about 8 to 10%. So 2x the time is correct, but the percentage of media spend is about between 8 to 10%. Digital itself is about 16 to 18% projected for this year of the overall marketing spend. Okay, the other interesting thing is that Facebook says that with mobile ads with duration ranging less than 1 second, 0.92 seconds, can also be effective, okay, in driving brand awareness, brand consideration. This is about the time that Dhoni takes to do a stumping. Okay, that kind of a time is fine. Exposure of that kind of time to an ad is fine to drive many things. Interesting point. Okay, third and fourth points together. Neuroscience seems to indicate that people actually use much faster thinking when they're engaging with the mobile. It's a proven fact. And I'll just talk about this in a little bit more of detail a little later. Brand, and of course the point on measurement. There is no better measurement metric than that on either brand health measures or direct sales. These are the two measures which are the best measures of campaign effectiveness on mobile. Okay, everything else is sort of just there. Okay, now these are some facts which I'm sure you guys are aware of. Penetration is very high. Time spent on mobile is very high. I was quite surprised to see this data that Indians spend approximately 200 minutes a day. 200 minutes a day on the mobile. If any of you guys have your screen time indicator available right now, you can check how much screen time, how much is the screen time till now. I'm sure it would be up to 2 hours till now itself. So the time spent on mobile is very high, and yet mobile marketing investment still lags this dramatic change in the consumer behavior. So why does this really happen? So 3 very big key pain points of all marketers vis-a-vis mobile. Yeah. Firstly, what share of our overall advertising, should be allocated to mobile? Secondly, how should we execute mobile in a manner which is, which makes it more useful in the context of an integrated campaign? And thirdly, how should we use mobile as a medium better to maximize the performance on our media investments? And I think all these 3 points can be addressed under 2 sub-points of efficacy and efficiency. And typically, efficacy and efficiency are factors which can cover pretty much all the other media vehicles as well. But let us see what efficacy and efficiency mean in the context of the mobile. So starting with efficacy, the point I'm making is that when people consume content on the mobile, they show 3 very clear characteristics which make it very different, which make it very distinct from other screens like TV or desktop, etc. The first one is that all the mobile consumption is very intense and very, very immediate. Secondly, it's very immersive and impactful. And thirdly, it's very impatient. So if I had to just get into the details. Okay, the first two I's actually, intense and immediate. Consumers are actually able to recall content from the mobile newsfeed with as little as 0.9 seconds of exposure. This is the Facebook thing that I was talking to you about. This is because mobile engages their attention fully. So what neuroscience indicates is that mobile promotes a way of brain working, which is called system one. So there are two kinds of way in which the brain works, system one and system two, like the rational side and the irrational side, you know, left side, right side of the brain. So mobile actually works on the fast thinking system. And what are the key measures of the fast thinking brain? It gets you to be very spontaneous, very impulsive, very emotional, and very associative. So when you're consuming content on mobile, you are displaying these four or five parameters. And this is the reason why you should never have any discussion on WhatsApp, especially for any political arguments, etc. Because you are just so impulsive. You are so and the same thing used to be said about Facebook earlier. But this is the reality on WhatsApp. Have any of you resolved any argument on WhatsApp ever with any of you changing your mind? Nobody changes their mind on WhatsApp because you are displaying the system one kind of thinking, which is impulsive, emotional, associative, spontaneous. There's no rationality here at all because that's how mobile content is consumed. It is intense and it is very immediate. Okay, the other one. The other point here is immersive and impactful. When people are immersed in their mobiles, they are completely oblivious to anything else. And they are unresponsive to external stimulus. Even now, people who are looking at their WhatsApp are actually oblivious to what I'm presenting because you're just so consumed by what you are seeing on your WhatsApp. But that's the reality of the mobile phone. Yeah? So I think, so again, some of these points are very lifelike. Have any of you had this kind of a conversation with your better half? This or that, depending on your gender. So I've covered both the genders here, so that I'm not blamed. Both the genders are covered here. And this kind of conversation is a very normal conversation, yeah? Because actually, this is how mobile is consumed. It just forces you to be very, to become completely oblivious to everything else. Oh, sorry. One point which I missed here. Yeah, the same study also found that if you show the same ad stimulus on a smartphone versus television, actually people will show a greater amount of attention to the stimulus shown on the mobile phone. And that is because they look at the mobile phone, things on mobile phone with a lot more concentration. Yeah, that's the point. The third point. When you are talking about mobile marketing, what is your TG? Your TG is actually the goldfish or the goldfish TG. Why am I calling it the goldfish TG? The average attention span of a human being in the year 2000 was about 12 to 13 seconds. It's now come down to about 8 seconds. Okay, amongst all living beings, the goldfish is supposed to have the least amount of attention span, which is about 9 seconds. So when you are consuming a mobile, your average attention span is lower than that of a goldfish. That is the kind of target audience you have. So the TG on the mobile is very, very impatient. Yeah, mobile visits last about one third of a desktop, one third as long. You know, in the course of half an hour, you would probably check your mobile about 15 times, even when you are sitting in front of your desktop. Yeah. So people really don't pause to watch interruptive advertising as such. Yeah. Because it exceeds their attention span. They don't wait for an ad to come on the mobile and to fully finish before moving on to something else. And that's the attention span problem. So impatient, that's why they're very, very impatient. And if you look at the traditional marketing, which is the entire ABCD, ad must cut through attention, brand must get recognized, communication must adapt to the medium, delivery ad must deliver to the intended message. When you're marketing on the mobile, you have to follow these four ABCDs again, but keeping in mind those five I's that I spoke about. So the ABCD of mobile is actually different. Oh, what happened here? Yeah. Oops. This guy is not my friend, huh? Yeah. So the ABCD of mobile marketing is actually a little different from the ABCD of traditional marketing. When it comes to attention, the point on mobile marketing is that you need to minimize the need to click. Minimize the need to click to see the ad. You know, get into things like autoplay, hyperlapse, you know, all of those kind of tools so that you don't have, the guy does not have to press, you know, use his finger to click. So no user action should be required. Attention, branding. Your ad should be branded from the very first second. Very first second, because like I said, you know, some people may not even see or, may not move to the second at all. Communicate for the small screen. Make an ad without sound and see if it works without sound. If it doesn't work without sound, it will not work for mobile. Okay, a lot of people right in this room are looking at their Facebook right now. They're consuming ads. They're looking at, you know, the various advertising which is happening. And obviously the sound is not on. Yeah, because it would look very rude. So your ad has to work without sound for these guys, for everybody here, to be able to look at the ad without sound. What you can do is that you can do things like use subtitles, as most of the mobile ads are viewed with the sound off. So that's a very new way of, you know, you can't have the normal TVC running on the mobile. It's not going to work. And the last point being on delivery. Yeah. You have to deliver the message. Whatever you want to say, say it in the first few seconds and get out. Don't get into too much contextualization, which is why it is important for you to build the message, you know, build the whole branding angle and what you want to say very, 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 very quickly. At best, the duration of your ad should not exceed more than 5 seconds. Okay, anything over and above that is pure luxury. So this is the new ABCD of mobile marketing, which everybody has to work on. Efficiency. Now we come to the whole measurement point. Measure what you need and not what is available. Okay, what is available is everything. How did our ad perform on your network? Is my time up? No, not really. It performed great. Your metrics is up, this. The point is there are 1,000 metrics available for you to work on. But you need to take a step back. You need to ask yourself, what was my objective? Is it more website visit? What was it? And then only come to the, you know, come to your actual KPIs. Yeah, so set your relevant KPIs right in the beginning along with your agency. Don't struggle later on, you know, for what were my KPIs. And measure for exactly that. Try not to get blinded by things like how many likes your video has had, how many shares it has had, how many views. It is important to know these points. But these are not the, you know, they may not be the right metrics for the kind of ad you want to run. Okay, so don't get blinded by what is available. Only focus on what you want, what you really need. Because there are pretty much measurement solutions available for everything. You can measure your offline sales. You can measure your brand measures, how the brand measures have gone up, online sales. So everything, CPM, things like CPM and CPR can be a measure of efficiency. But you also need to balance for measurement of efficacy. You can have a banner ad placed at the corner of a website and we feel very happy about it. But a much more expensive impression right in the center or more relevant place may actually give you a much higher sales lift. So be very mindful of things like CPM, etc. So what is the ROI bottom line? I think first thing you need to understand is that mobile marketing is not done in isolation. Okay, it is done along with television, print, radio, you know, all of that, everything, etc. So you have to be, instead of getting worried too much about the ROI of mobile marketing, just mobile marketing, you have to look at how your integrated multimedia campaign has performed. Start by identifying your campaign objectives. Optimize your overall media mix. Try to use a good marketing mix model to evaluate and reallocate your budgets. And look at the effectiveness of different platforms when you're doing that. Know your TG a lot better. We just spoke about it using relevant data. And identify the right touch points. I don't know if mobile even makes sense for you. Maybe it doesn't make sense for you. You know, one doesn't know. Or the other way around. Maybe only mobile makes sense for you. Television doesn't make sense for you. So first, you identify the right touch points. Yeah. And like I said earlier, focus on both, not just efficiency for mobile. Focus on both the efficacy and efficiency, you know, for mobile. And once your campaign has started, so firstly, you need to do a pre-cross-media research just to understand where you are currently. So, for example, if you're trying to measure some brand health measures, you know, and you want them to improve, you first need to get a pre-analysis. What is it currently? And what do you want to do post that, yeah? So both pre- and post-research during the campaign and after the campaign is very important to understand whether the needles have moved or not moved. And it will also help you to re-optimize your campaign. And the last one, probably the most important one, patience. Learn you must. This is something that none of us have, by the way. I mean, especially the mobile marketeers, because one of the eyes was what? Impatience. Yeah? So there is a bit of contradiction here. But with mobile marketing campaigns, you have to be patient, like you have to be patient with every other media campaign. Yeah. So what are the key takeaways? What have we discussed just now? It's obviously a massive opportunity. To exploit it at its best, you need to have a proper collaboration between agencies and marketeers using the shared trust and upskill module. Focus on measuring both efficacy and efficiency. Remember the 5 I's when you're doing the mobile marketing. Remodel ABCDs for mobile marketing. Don't use the ABCD of traditional marketing in mobile marketing. And measure what you need, not what is available for you. That's it. That's all I had to say, and I have 14 seconds left. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very, very engaging presentation there. Also on the behavioral patterns of all us millennials over here. On that note, what I'm going to do is invite Chanan Sahni, Head of Digital Marketing Consumer India with Johnson & Johnson, to please come on stage and present a token of gratitude to our fantastic speaker here, Mr. Sandeep Verma. Can we have a huge round of applause one more time, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you once again.